Last time on 1 vs 100, we saw Paul chip away at the 100, but eventually he ran out of both his dodges and his luck. Mark replaced him and for a while looked like he was on for a big win, but a single stubborn opponent, Hannah, stopped him in his tracks. This week, Hannah's back as the new one herself. Can she go one better than Mark? We're about to find out.
Welcome to 1 vs 100.
Saturday night. Welcome to the National Lottery 1 vs 100 Arena for the last in the current series of the most competitive show on TV with your host, Ben Shepherd.
Good evening and welcome to 1 vs 100, the show where one contestant takes on 100 opponents. Keep answering questions correctly and they could win some serious cash. But get just one question wrong and they're out. Someone else from the 100 taking their place. Amongst our 100 tonight, we have two sales consultants, there's a plumber, a fraud investigator, we've got a powerboat instructor as well, so quite a mix. As usual, they all want to play. But last week, we saw Hannah end up as the last remaining member of the 100, so she is the new one to take on tonight's 100. Hannah, you are the one. Please, enter the arena.
The one to take on the 100 is Hannah Warner, a full-time mum from Lincolnshire. Hannah's clearly not fazed by taking on new and unfamiliar challenges. She went hang gliding in New Zealand despite being petrified of heights. So beware, 100. This lady means business.
Hello, everybody!
Hello.
How are you feeling?
I'm half very excited and half very nervous.
You're a mum?
I am. I'm a full-time mum. I've got three children under five.
Goodness.
Izzy's four, Joe's three, and Seth's 9 months.
9 months?
Yes, yeah, so there's not a lot of sleeping going on in our house.
No. What would you like to do if you won this money?
My dream, I'd love to have a holiday home, somewhere to take the kids, somewhere you could go at the weekend, you know, after a hard week at school, and you can just say, right, we're going to the seaside, that'd be great.
Well, look, Hannah, we want you to get just that by the end of tonight's show.
Okay.
So here's how it's going to be. You are the one, they are your 100. I'm going to ask you a series of questions. Both you and the 100 are going to answer. Every time you get a question right, each member of the 100 who gets it wrong is eliminated. Your aim is to keep going till they are all gone. If you do that, you'll walk away with all the money you've made plus an extra £50,000 for beating the 100. But if you get just one question wrong, Hannah, you're going to go home with absolutely nothing. Digital viewers, you can play along at home right now by pressing your red button, so good luck to you. Is it Hannah? You ready to play?
Go on then. I can do it.
100, are you ready to play?
Yes!
Okay, let's play 1 vs 100. I'm going to give you two categories for every question that you get asked. So let's have a look at your first two. Hollywood greats or politics?
Okay, it'll have to be Hollywood greats.
We'll have a Hollywood greats question, please. Which Hollywood legend was nicknamed the Duke? A. James Dean. B. Clark Gable. Or C. John Wayne? Members of the 100, you have 6 seconds to register your answers, starting now. The Duke.
Okay, I do think I know this, though.
Which one do you reckon it is?
I think it's John Wayne.
Any reason why?
I just think it is. Okay. So let me just get out of the way.
Okay, we're going to go with C, John Wayne, please. We need this one to get through to start playing for some money. Is the answer C, John Wayne? Yeah!
Oh,
of course it is! Please reveal who from the 100 got that answer wrong. 14 of them got it wrong. That's £14,000. Okay. It's you versus 86. Okay, you've got that money in the bank now, £14,000.
Yeah.
You can boost your winnings by playing your double, which means that any money you receive from knocking out your opponents will be doubled, £2,000 per person. You can also guarantee your survival by using a dodge. If you do play a dodge, you won't have to give me the answer. The remaining members of the 100 will, though. However, it's going to cost you. The price of survival is we slash your prize fund in half. Having said that, and most importantly, you will stay in the game.
Okay.
Let's have your next two categories, please. Food and drink or travel?
I'll take a chance on food and drink.
OK, food and drink, please. Which of these is the name of a cut of beef? A, Baron. B, Duke. C, Earl. Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting. Cuts of beef.
I could not have less of a clue. I've got absolutely no idea.
None of them sound vaguely like a beefy-type cut.
If there was anything, I would say, I don't know, perhaps an earl of beef. I know it's really early to be playing a dodge, but I've got to have to do it because I have not a clue.
OK, it's only the second question, and we're going to have to use our dodge. We halve your money, that's down to £7,000. If it was going to be any of them, you would have gone for Earl.
Yes, but I mean, yeah,
it's the most beefy.
Yeah.
We'll go for C, Earl, please. Is the answer C, Earl? It was Baron. You would have gone. Please reveal you've got that answer wrong. £37 got it wrong. The total after the dodge is £7,000. Hannah, it's you versus 49.
Well, I don't feel as bad now.
It didn't feel as bad. Do you have your next two categories?
Yes, please.
OK, here they come. Celebrities or human body?
It's got to be celebrities.
OK. Celebrities, please. David Beckham has his wife Victoria's name tattooed on his arm in which language? A, Arabic. B, Chinese. Or C, Hindi. Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting.
I'm sure it's Chinese, but it's that element of doubt. I can remember it, and I know they had it done, but I'm just not confident about which language it was in. I'm going to have to dodge, and I know which again.
But so you
again,
definitely want to dodge it?
Yes, I'm sorry, yes.
OK, we're going to play our second dodge. Your money's gone down to £3,500. So you think it's Chinese?
I think it's Chinese. But there's just this sort of 10% of me thinks it might be Hindi.
We're going with B, Chinese, please. Is the answer B, Chinese? It was Hindi.
It was the right thing to do, right.
Will you please reveal the reds? £29 got it wrong. Your total after the dodge is £3,500. Hannah, it's you versus 20. We've lost the plumber, the fraud investigator, our powerboat instructor. In 3 questions, there's only 20 of them left.
Okay.
You've got one dodge and you've got your double. Let's have a look at your next two categories. History or your bonus dodge. You've knocked out over 75 of your opponents, which means you get a chance to earn that extra dodge. If you get the question wrong, you're going to be out. One of the remaining members will take your place.
Yeah. Well, it's going to have to be the bonus dodge.
OK, it's an audio question.
Okay.
Have a listen to this. So, prepare the song. Which 2007 fantasy film featured that song? A, Eragon. B, The Golden Compass. Or C, Stardust. Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting. Like films?
Well, I do like my films, but obviously, having 3 children, I've been to the cinema once since 2004.
But do you know which one it is?
I do know, because I'm a big Take That fan, going to see them soon when
they're
touring.
Very exciting.
And I've watched the video many times. I think it was Stardust. And I think I'm going to play my double.
We're very confident we're going to double on this bonus dodge question, please. And we think the answer's C, Stardust.
Yes, just get on with it, because I can't bear it anymore.
Is the answer C, Stardust? Well done.
Yeah. Well done.
Of course, it was Take That of Rule the World. You knew that.
I didn't know that.
OK, we've got an extra dodge, which is great. And for every red light we see, okay, you get £2,000.
Oh, yes.
Please reveal who got that answer wrong. Seven. Seven of them got it wrong. £7,000 will double to £14,000. Your new total, £17,500. Hannah, it's you versus 13. Thank you. OK, let's get your next two categories. The calendar or entertainment?
On entertainment.
Entertainment?
Yes, we'll go for that. Yes, please.
Entertainment question, please. The Brit award-winning singer Lamar first rose to fame on which TV talent show? A, Fame Academy. B, Pop Idol. C, Star for a Night. Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting.
I know this.
Definitely?
I definitely know this because I love TV talent shows. I watch them all.
Right.
So, I think it is A, Fame Academy.
A, Fame Academy. A, Fame Academy. Is that the correct answer? Yes!
Yeah.
Well done. Well done, well done. Please reveal who got that answer wrong. Two of them got it wrong. £2,000. Your new total is £19,500. Hannah, it's you versus 11. So you've been scything them down in great big lumps now.
I know, it's chip, chip, chip now,
isn't it? It's the hardcore.
It's really hard.
Let's get your next two categories. Art or fictional characters?
OK, and my interest in art is probably that of a three-year-old.
OK.
So I'm going to have to go for fictional characters.
We'll have fictional characters, please. Played by Matt Damon on screen, former agent Jason Bourne is the creation of which author? A, Tom Clancy. B, Jack Higgins. Or C, Robert Ludlum. Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting. You're on course to take home £80,500. You've got two dodges.
Yeah.
And there's only 11 left to beat.
Oh, this is not a good one for me.
Do you know the series at all?
I've watched all the films, but I obviously haven't done enough credit reading. You know, I think it's Tom Clancy. I'm not going to risk it now. I'm going to play a dodge, please.
OK, we're going to use one of the two dodges on this question. So we halve your fund, that goes down to 9,750. So you're leaning towards Tom Clancy?
I am.
Okay. We'd like Tom Clancy, please. Is the answer A, Tom Clancy?
Oh,
Robert Ludlum.
Oh, thank goodness, yes!
Goodness me, well done, well done indeed. Every single dodge you've used, and you've used a few.
I know.
Has been used brilliantly. Please reveal who got that question wrong. Five of them got it wrong. Your total after the dodge stands at £9,750. It's you versus six.
Come on. Right, stay patient. Oh my goodness.
Okay, so we're on course to take home over £65,000.
Okay, that'd be lovely.
Let's get your next two categories. Geography or television?
It's going to have to be television.
Okay, we're going to go with TV, please. In the children's TV show In the Night Garden, what form of transport is the Ninky Nonk? A, airship. B, lorry. or C, train? Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting. I'm looking at them all and they're all shaking their heads.
Okay.
Now, I know,
yeah, I know the
you've
show.
Got three
I know
little children.
I know.
So you know In the Night Garden?
Yeah, of course I know In the Night Garden.
What's the ninky-nonk?
Right, and there are two modes of transport. One is a train and one is an airship. One's called the ninky-nonk.
Right.
And one's called the pinky-ponk.
So the ninky-nonk is?
I'm not sure which one's which.
Let's look at the guy.
Okay.
The guy up there with the necklace. Think he knows a ninky-nonk from a plinky-plonk?
Oh, he's looking quite confident, though I'm not sure. Okay, I'm going to have to gamble. At some stage in the game, I'm going to have to gamble. So I'm, without a dodge. So I'm going to gamble now. I think the ninky-nonk is a train.
Okay, so trusting our instinct, we're going to go with C, train.
I can't watch.
Okay, this is serious. There's £65,750 riding on this answer.
Such a lot of money.
You've got one dodge, but you've ignored that. You've gone with your instinct. Is the ninky-nonk C, a train? We need a ninky-nonk down here. Please reveal who got that wrong. Three of them got it wrong. That's £3,000. Your total is £12,750. It's you versus three. So there's only three opponents left. Three lovely ladies up the top there. Good luck to all three of you. Hannah, good luck to you as well.
Thank you.
Let's have your next two categories. Cities or sport?
OK. It's going to have to be sport.
Sport, please. In Australian rules football, how many points are scored for a goal? A4, B5 or C6? The last three members of the 100. You have 6 seconds and counting.
I've never seen it played, even when I travelled into Australia a few years ago. Never once saw a game there, never seen it in this country. So knowing how many points are scored for a goal, well, actually, no, I just haven't got a clue. If I had to guess, it rings a bell to say 4, but I don't have a clue. And at this stage of the game, if I have one chance of another, of a dodge, I'm going to have to use it. So I am going to have to use the dodge, my last dodge, I know.
We'll take the dodge for this one, please. OK, so we thought the answer could be 4. If those three have got this answer wrong, you could be going home with £56,375.
Okay.
Is A the right answer? Six. Oh. You're very wrong. Well done. Again. So this is it. £56,375 ride on whether they're all wrong or one of them's got it right. I can tell you that Gillian got the answer wrong. That Naomi got the answer wrong. So we come down to you and Catherine. If she's got it wrong, you're going home with £56,375. I can tell you, Catherine got the answer. Wrong. They're out. You've done it.
£56,375.
What's your husband going to say?
He won't mind staying at home looking after all three kids for that.
Hannah, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you come and play. You've played a superb game and we're a worthy champion. Hannah, everybody! So Hannah has left £56,375, better off than when she arrived, which will certainly pay for her family's seaside retreat. We're going to choose a new one to take on the 100 after we've been live to the National Lottery HQ for the first of tonight's lottery draws, which are Thunderball and Dream Number. Over to the gorgeous Jenny Faulkner.
We are live and direct from National Lottery HQ on this Saturday, the 23rd of May, with not only a lotto rollover, but also the dazzling Jenny Faulkner.
Thank you, I'm not trying to dazzle. Good evening and welcome to Saturday's National Lottery Draws.
And so, Miss Faulkner, it's lovely to have you back with us, obviously. Are you raring to go?
Certainly am, I always am. Can't wait to get those balls rolling tonight and make somebody somewhere very rich indeed. So, tickets at the ready as we play the first live draw of the night, which is, of course, the one and only Thunderball. Here, Saturday's Dream Team, Drawmaster Matt Chamberlain and Independent Adjudicator Sian Fleet-Mill. Now, they're both here to make sure everything ticks along nicely this evening. So, Alan, that's it. The scene is now set. Please, take away. Do what you do best.
Matt, release those bank holiday balls, please. Now, as I'm sure you know, 34 balls in this first machine. We're about to pick five of them. Tonight, we're using Excalibur and Centerball 6, chosen for us at random earlier today by John Hoare, who's from High Wycombe. The latest news from the draw team is that over 115,000 tickets won a prize on Wednesday. 11 of them matched with the first five main numbers to win £5,000 apiece. Just think, you can be about to win this game's top prize, £250,000. Jenny.
And that is a lot of money. OK then, Drawmaster Matt, are we ready to rock?
Yes, we are.
Excellent. OK, these next numbers could be just the ticket. Start the draw.
Here we go, spinning and winning on a Saturday night. And the first one tonight looks a little bit like that, number 14. And the next one, which is it to be? Well, the answer is right there, 31. Third to be drawn tonight is that one there, 23. How are you doing so far? Well, I hope. A couple more needed from this, our first machine. Here's the first of them, 22. And the last ball from this, our first machine, looks a bit like that. And it's number 10. OK, Matt and Sian, move over to the second machine, if you would, please. Start that one up and release the 14 red thunderballs. Now, it depends on how many you've matched with so far, but matching one of these beauties as well could be good news. Jenny.
Oh, yes, it could, because all you need to do to start winning on this game here is to match one ball from the first machine plus the thunderball. The more you match, the more you win. And remember that this is your best chance of winning £250,000 on any National Lottery game. Here we go. Your weekend could be about to get a massive boost. Start the draw.
Yeah, let's hope so. Good luck from me too. Here we go. Which is it going to be? The answer is right there, number 11. So, here are tonight's Thunderball numbers again, only this time in ascending order. 10, 14, 22, 23, and number 31. The Thunderball, number 11. Jenny.
Right then, time now to change some more lives this Saturday night, this time with Dream Number. Let's do it. And And by playing Dream Number, you're helping to fund facilities such as the Velodrome, which will be used in the London 2012 Olympic and Paralympic Games. So, Drawmaster Matt, are we ready to make even more winners?
Yes, we are, Jenny.
Excellent. Your luck might be about to change for the better. Start the draw.
Oh, let's hope so. Tonight, we're using Tourmaline and Centerball's number 4, chosen by Mr. H. And the news from Wednesday's Dream Number draw is that there are over 39,000 winning tickets. One very lucky ticket matched with the first 6 numbers drawn in sequence to win £50,000. Just imagine. Well done, some of that cash. Get in your direction on Wednesday night. Right, here we go. First one tonight is... that one there, a 9. Now, if you match with that number, you're definitely in the game tonight. £2 is yours. You're off and running. Here's the next one. Here it comes. And it is... a 1. You match with those first 2 numbers in that order. Prize money now stands at a tenner. Well done. Next tonight... 8. And don't forget, in this game, you have a 1 in 10 chance of winning a prize. Here's another one for you. That's another 9. If you match correctly with the 4 numbers drawn so far, £500 is yours. There's a 4. You must match with these numbers in sequence, though, with no breaks in the chain, please. Next one. Which is it to be? It's making us wait tonight. There's another 9. You're watching tonight's Dream Number Draw live on BBC One. Last number in the sequence tonight is... that one there, a 4. So, tonight's National Lottery dream number is... 9. 1. 8. 9. 4. 9. 4. Jenny.
Thanks, Alan. That's your lot for now. But don't go anywhere, because we will be back very soon with the big Lotto rollover draw. And don't forget, you can play along with the 1 versus 100 contestants by simply pressing the red button.
Oh.
Right then, Ben, back to you.
Thank you. Back here before the lottery, we saw Hannah go off with a hard-earned £56,375. Digital viewers, I hope you did as well as Hannah. So who will be the next one chosen to take on the 100? Let's find out. You are the one. Please enter the arena.
The next one to challenge the 100 is Mark Coley, a staff nurse from Doncaster. He loves singing, playing instruments and doing impressions. Will Mark's performance experience help him keep his nerve? We're about to find out.
Mark, everybody! Hey, Mark.
Hi, Ben.
Lovely to see you. How are you doing?
Not so bad.
You're a nurse, I understand.
I'm a staff nurse, yes.
And who do you work with?
I work with adults with severe learning disabilities in a daycare centre. So they have karaoke and art therapy. And I love singing, and I get to sing every day as well, as being a staff nurse.
So you sing for the patients?
I sing for them, yes. And I write songs as well. So.
You write songs?
Yeah.
So have you written a song for an auspicious occasion like tonight?
I have. I've written a song especially from 1 versus 100.
Really?
Would you like to hear it?
Oh, yes, we were.
Okay. 1 versus 100. I really want to play. 1 versus 100. I'm going all the way. Answer the questions one by one. 100 people soon be one. I want to win the money, cos I'm the one.
Wow. So you've sung for them?
Yes.
Now you just need to beat them?
Yes.
What would you like to do if you won this money?
Well, last year was our 10th wedding anniversary and we really wanted to go to Australia. So that's the first thing we'll do is plan a 4-week trip to Australia.
Fabulous. OK, now look, so you've seen how it works, Mark?
I have.
Are you ready to play?
I'm ready.
100, are you ready to play?
Yes!
OK, let's play 1 versus 100. You've got 2 categories to choose from for each question.
OK.
So let's get your first 2 up there, please. Leisure or natural world?
I think I'll go with leisure, Ben.
OK. We'll have leisure, please. Which colour belt is worn by a beginner in judo? A, black, B, pink, or C, white? Members of the 100, you've got 6 seconds and counting.
I've narrowed it down to 2. Yeah, I know it's not a black belt.
So it could be pink or white.
So it could be pink or white. Oh, this is awful.
Can't avoid this one, we need an answer.
I've not heard of a pink one, but I have heard of a white. I'm gonna have to go with white.
C, white, please. At this early stage, if that's wrong, Mark, I'm afraid you're going home. Is the answer C, white? Well done! Great start. Please reveal from the 100 who got that answer wrong. Only 6 got it wrong. It's a great start, though, because you've got £6,000. Mark, it's you versus 94. Okay, now you've got that £6,000 in the bank, you can boost your winnings by using your double, or you can stay in the game by employing one of the 3 dodges, okay? Let's have a look at your next 2 categories, please. Films or human body?
I do watch a lot of films. So I'm going to go with films, Ben.
We're going to have a go at films, please. In the animated movie, Horton Hears a Who, what type of animal is Horton? A, elephant. B, hippopotamus. C, giraffe. Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting. You watch a lot of films?
I do.
Have you seen Horton Hears a Who?
I have not seen the film, but I've seen clips of it, and I think I know, but I'm not 100%.
Which one do you think it is?
I think it's Elephant.
OK.
I remember seeing a picture of the character, and it's got a trunk. I'm sure it's Elephant. And some of them might not know, and I want to use my double now. Yeah.
OK, we're going to throw the double into the mix, please. And we think Horton is A, an elephant. Is Horton A, an elephant? Well done.
Yes.
Cracking stuff. Cracking stuff, Mark. Well done. Please reveal who got that answer wrong. That is a lot of lights. 31 got it wrong. 31,000 doubled is 62,000. Your new total stands at 68,000. Mark, it's you versus 63. That's the biggest double of the series.
Fantastic.
There's 63 of them left. If you can beat them, £181,000 would be yours to take home. Let's have a look at your next 2 categories, please. Astrology or world affairs?
I think I'll go for World Affairs.
Right then, World Affairs it is. What is the first name of US President Barack Obama's wife? A, Marcia. B, Melanie. Or C, Michelle. Remaining members of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting. Marcia, Melanie. Michelle.
I should know this, it's just been in the news a lot. And I'm just not sure. I think Melanie rings a bell. I'm just not sure enough. I'm gonna have to use my first dodge.
Okay, we're gonna play our first dodge with this one, please.
I think Melanie rings a bell.
We'll go for B, Melanie, please. So far, Mark has beaten 37 of his opponents and has £34,000 in the bank. If he keeps getting questions right, he could be taking home £147,000. We're going to find out if you can do that after we go live to the National Lottery HQ for tonight's big lotto draw. They're all yours, Jen.
Thanks, Ben. They're all mine now. welcome back to Lottery HQ. Now, Saturday's Dream Team, alongside an independent adjudicator, are busy preparing up there for that big lotto rollover draw, which will take place very, very soon. And for all the latest lottery news, including today's daily play results, visit BBC Online or press that red button.
And there'll be a lottery update right here on BBC One, round about 10:15.
There will indeed. But now it's time for tonight's lotto, and it's a biggie this evening, because remember, it is a rollover. So without further ado, let's do it. It's that time. It's jackpot time. I'm hoping for a lot of money in there tonight, so don't keep us in suspense. Yep. How much are we looking at, please?
Well, you're going to need a pretty big purse, because tonight's rollover jackpot's an estimated £7.4 million.
A massive purse, that one. OK, then, voice of the balls, take it away. Do your weekend thing.
Matt, release those rollover balls. Topaz and Circles 3 we're using. Over 258,000 tickets won a prize midweek. Three of them matched with five plus the bonus to scoop up £284,000 each. Oh, well, we just must mention, there's a lotto prize worth over £280,000 still up for grabs on a ticket bought in the East Hampshire area. But you've only got until 5:30 on Thursday to claim that prize. Go to BBC Online for all the details. Jenny?
Yeah, don't miss out on that one. OK, then, Drawmaster, are we good to go?
Yes, we're good to go.
Excellent. To everyone playing along tonight, the very best of luck. Start your draw!
We are off and running, and the first one is right there, number 48, completed Millionaire's Row just the four Wednesdays back. That 176th time now as a Lotto main ball. And the next one, please, is number 41, 141st time as a Lotto main ball, with us four weekends back as well. And the third to be drawn is right there, number 32, 180th time as a main Lotto ball, with us three Saturdays back and a couple of Wednesdays on the trot as well. And the next is number 17. I've seen that a couple of weekends running recently. 196th time now. It's graced us with its presence. And the fifth one, please, is right there, number 44. Also, sorry, Leap and Sapphire, all of 11 Saturdays back. 211th time we've seen that one now. And the sixth one is number 12. This makes its 179th appearance now as a Lotto main ball, with us as bonus the Saturday before last. The bonus tonight is number 15. So, this weekend's winning Lotto numbers in ascending order are 12, 17, 32. Then look at this run of 40s, 41, 44, and number 48. The bonus, 15. Miss Falconer.
Thank you, Mr. Dedicott. That's it for tonight. But next week, Gethin Jones is your host on Wednesday at 10:40 for the midweek draws. I'll be back next Saturday at 8:10 with the weekend draws. And I'm very excited because my special guest will be Daniel Day-Kim, who's also known as Jin from Lost.
Oh, and we really hope tonight's numbers were lucky for you, don't we?
Oh, we do indeed. For now, though, from all of us here, enjoy the bank holiday. I hope it's sunny where you are. And for the last time in this current series, it's back to Ben in the 1 versus 100 arena. Good night.
Thank you. Before the lottery, we saw Mark knock out 37 of his opponents. So far, he's got £34,000 in the bank. He's dodged this question, but he's still on course to win over £147,000. What is the first name of US President Barack Obama's wife? A, Marcia. B, Melanie. C, Michelle. We've gone for B, Melanie, having dodged the question. Yeah. Is the answer B, Melanie? Michelle. Michelle,
well done.
Please reveal who got that answer wrong. Four of them got it wrong. Your total after the dodge is £34,000. Mark, it's you versus 59. Get your next two categories. Okay. Actors and actresses, or people and places?
I want to go with actors and actresses.
OK, let's have a look at actors and actresses, please. Published in 2008, My Word Is My Bond is the autobiography of which film star? A, Pierce Brosnan, B, Sean Connery, or C, Roger Moore? You love your films?
Don't think it's Pierce Brosnan. I think it's between Sean Connery and Roger Moore.
You've got two dodges. You've got £34,000. Potentially, you could win £143,000.
I'm going towards Roger Moore, but I'm not that confident. I think I don't really want to play with dodge, but I think I'm going to have to because I'm not that confident.
OK, we're going to play our second dodge with this one, please. So, between Sean Connery and Roger Moore, if I was forcing your hand...
Roger Moore, I would have gone for.
Roger Moore, then C. Is C the correct answer? Was... You're right the whole time, aren't you? Please, reveal the reds. 24 got it wrong. Your total after the dodge stands at £17,000. Mark, it's you versus 35.
It's okay. Not bad. It's okay. It's bad.
Let's get the next two categories up, please. Art or sport?
This is quite an easy choice. Not very good on sport, so I'm going to go with art.
OK, straight in with the art, please.
Yeah.
Here it is. Which Italian art gallery is the home of Michelangelo's sculpture David? A, Accademia, B, Borghese, or C, Uffizi?
I'm aware of the sculpture of David, but I have no idea about which art gallery, and I can't risk it. I'm going to have to dodge it again.
OK, we're going to play our third and final dodge, please. Halved your money, £8,500. Could still be taking home £93,500. Accademia, Borghese, Uffizi?
Accademia, I would have guessed, as a pure guess.
OK, we're going to go with A, Accademia. Is the answer A, Accademia? It was.
No.
So this is going to be interesting now.
It will be interesting.
Please reveal the reds. 34, got it wrong. Your total after the dodge is £8,500. Mark, it's you versus Douglas. I think we should say hello. Goodness me, Douglas. 35 of them in there. You were the only one to get it right. Did you know that one?
It was kind of an educated guess.
Where did it come from?
I just thought, Academy, he's an intelligent guy. I'm sure that's where that word came from. I don't know.
OK. Good luck, Douglas. Good luck, Mark.
Thank you.
Let's see your next two categories. Science or bonus dodge? Get the question wrong, you're going to be out. Douglas gets it right. He'll be taking your place.
I think I need to do the bonus dodge.
Bonus dodge question is an audio question, so have a listen to this. And though you turn from me to glance behind, the phantom of the opera is there inside your Lily, you know it.
Yes.
Let's see what the question is. In which city is this musical mainly set? A, Paris. B, London. C, Vienna. Douglas, as the only remaining member of the 100, you have 6 seconds and counting.
I think I know it, but my gut instinct says it is Paris, but then Vienna springs to mind. Paris or Vienna? Oh, I've got a feeling it's Paris. My gut instincts before have been right, and I've been dodging.
Yeah.
But this is my last chance.
There is £59,500 riding on this answer.
Paris.
If you get it right, and Douglas has got it wrong, that money will be yours.
I'm going to go with My gut instinct. I've been to Paris. I proposed to my wife on Valentine's Day in Paris. I'm doing this for my wife. I'm gonna go for A, Paris.
Who'd like A, please, Paris? You've given me your answer. Douglas has given me his answer as well. I can tell you, Mark, Douglas is wrong. You've been the 100, you've done it! So, you've got a decision to make.
Yes.
I'm going to give you the choice to bail now. If you walk away, you can take £9,500 home. You won't collect the extra £50,000 for beating the 100. If you choose not to bail, if you think the answer is Paris, and you're right, you'll be going home with £59,500. It's a life-changing amount of money.
It is.
If you think you've got the answer right, go for it, and you're wrong, you'll lose everything. Are you feeling brave, or are you going to bail?
I must go with my instinct. Just Paris is a special place for me, and it's a life-changing amount of money. I've got to go for it.
He's going to go for it. Okay. If you're right, you're taking home £59,500. Is it A, Paris?
Incredible job.
Wow. £59,500. What sort of a difference will that make to your life?
It would make a big difference. I've always wanted to go to Australia, but I've just never, ever dreamed that I'd win that amount of money, ever.
Maybe you should stop off in Paris on the way to Australia.
Definitely go to Paris.
Because everything points to Paris. What an amazing place that is.
It's an amazing place.
You've been an extraordinary competitor. We've really, really enjoyed having you on the show.
Thank you, Ben. I've really enjoyed it.
Mark, everybody.
Yes!
Is leaving with a superb £59,500, the most we've given away this series after a roller coaster ride of emotions. Paris might be for romantics, but with all that cash, Mark's going to be jetting off to his dream destination, Australia. I'm afraid, though, that's the end of the series. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. We're off for a lie down. Good night.